Namaste. Jai Shivai. So today, as you can see, I am here in this beautiful surrounding in the Penthill Mountains, and it's a very big state park. There are a lot of trees, and there is a green trees. Autumn is about to start, and there's a beautiful gorge behind me, and there are some ducks in it, and it's really, really beautiful today. So let's talk about something that I had in my mind from a long time, which is about sanctity, you know, when, and it's a more of a preparatory thing before you start your spiritual path. Before you start with your yoga sadhana, there is something called as sanctity in life. So you need to achieve that sanctity. How? Sanctity is not just of body. You will see a lot of people being really, really fanatic about physical sanctity. Oh, don't touch me, or stay away from me. I'll not eat food this way, that way. And, you know, it's not bad to have those things when you are walking your spiritual path. There's nothing wrong about it. You really have to maintain some physical sanctity, like taking shower every day, being very clean and nice from your physical body, taking care of if there's a problem in your body, just maintaining it well. That's how you would maintain your nice car, or you will maintain your house exactly in the same way you have to maintain your body. So, wow, what a nice breeze going on. You can hear the birds chirping in the background. Okay, let's talk. So this is the, see, even nature maintains a sanctity, you can say. You see how beautifully nature has all kinds of trees here, and birds, and flowers, and water in the gorge or a pond or somewhere, and these mountains, these Penthill Mountains. So nature in a way is always maintaining a sanctity. And nature, that is the reason when you go into the nature, you suddenly find yourself very peaceful, joyful. And those who are able to connect with the nature, they know what I'm talking about, right? How you feel when you are out in the forest. And since childhood, I used to play in India. I used to play in the backyard, in the forest reserve that we used to have at the back of our house. And I used to climb trees. I still can climb a tree, but this is a dead tree branch here where I can try to sit. Okay. So, you see, people I used to climb trees, and that's how I learned how to actually catch snakes and how to handle a lot of wildlife. And it was a magical time for me, very mystical time for me, the way I used to connect to nature. And I learned how things are in so much harmony all the time in nature. And trees may, inside, when the roots are inside the ground, then they might be competing for water or growth or life or oxygen or nitrogen and all that, those things. But from the top, you can see that one tree is actually giving shelter to the other tree. One tree is leaning on the other tree, and it's perfectly fine. So nature maintains a sanctity, right? Exactly in the same way, when you walk your spiritual path, you have to maintain a sanctity in your life. Now sanctity, not just from the point of view of your physical body, your annamaya kosha. Instead, the sanctity of your thoughts, your manomaya kosha. All the time, if you are thinking about how to pull other person down, how to compete with somebody, or how to drag somebody down, how to undermine somebody, how to take things for, if you are taking things for granted, and or if you are just beating yourself, I'm a bad person, I should have been this way, that way, and I am not, and I do not stand perfectly on the, you know, grounds of being into this relationship or that relationship. I have this fault in me, that fault in me. So all the time, if you are looking at bad things in others or in yourself, all the time if you are thinking about what wrong things others have or you have, what if you are full of negative thoughts all the time, thinking negatively, just, you know, then that's a very dirty thing to do. Very, very dirty thing to do.
That means you are not maintaining that sanctity. However clean you are and groomed you are from your physical body, however many white shirt and white pants and things you wear and all the time nice clothes you may wear, but if you do not have sanctity in your thoughts, in your head, if your head from inside looks very dirty because it has all kinds of negative thoughts. Before even you start in your life, you start with your first stepping stone is thinking about all the things that can go wrong, thinking about all the negative things. Then that means you're not maintaining a, you neither love yourself enough nor you love other people. Okay? You do not have samarpan. You do not have surrender to the life that is around you. The way you are born, the way you are, with some good qualities, some bad qualities. And in the same way, other people are born like that too. They have some good quality and some bad quality. So you are not maintaining a sanctity in your head. And when you do not have sanctity in your thoughts, then definitely your anatta is closed, your heart chakra is closed. You are always fearful about what wrong may happen, what other people may do to you, how much you stand a chance of being betrayed, and what needs to be done if you are betrayed, and how to handle this thing or that thing. You're always on a careful side, fearful side. So instead of choosing life, you start choosing fear. So sanctity in your thoughts is very important. Next thing is sanctity of energy. How do we maintain sanctity of energy? See, there are all kinds of negative people around you. World is full of them. You start, try doing one thing and people will come and tell you, no, you shouldn't be doing this. Otherwise, what if this happens, that happens, and you know, even if you try to get out of a bad relationship, there you will find people who will convince you against that. Convince you that, no, you shouldn't get out, and what if you won't be able to live alone, or what if, how will you take care of finances and this and that. So, you know, this is the way negative people, negativity surrounds you. In nature, if you come, there's no negativity. No tree is kicking you off. This tree is letting me sit, and even though this is a dead tree and the trees here break a lot in Australia because it doesn't rain much and it's more of a drought kind of a situation. So nature is not kicking you off. Nature is completely peaceful surroundings and there's no competition, and they are not throwing their bad carbon dioxide on you like other people go on throwing negative thoughts and negative energy on you. So you need to be careful for that. You need to stay away from such people who do not understand your path, who do not understand what you are doing. There comes a time when, okay, saying you should learn how to say, strictly say no. So I used to get a lot of, when I was walking my spiritual path, there came a time when I was going into sort of a seclusion from people, from society, from people around me, because they wouldn't know. They just saw me as a normal person going around, living life, working in IT. They didn't know that I am actually getting up at 3 a.m., starting my yogic sadhana at 3:40 a.m. They didn't know all that. They didn't know that I am awake twice or three times in a week all night and just writing and reading and thousands of ideas coming to my mind, and I'm working on that and thinking about those things, and that I am doing a contemplative meditation all the time. Means, why did this thought came? Why did that thought came? Or not just the thought, I was trying to reach deep down to all my vrittis, all the chitta vrittis that we have, all the sanskar that we are born with. So I was mostly into the contemplative meditation. And when you are in a contemplative meditation or thinking about something, you don't want to talk to useless people. You don't want to do useless talking. I anyways was a very reserved talker, you can say. Only unless until there is a dire necessity of talking, speaking, I wouldn't talk. I wouldn't speak a word. Neither I wanted to prove myself as something, nor I wanted to undermine the person who is in front of me, nor there was a need. A lot is left unsaid, and that's way much better than what you say. So you see, this is how people are around you. So when you are walking your spiritual path, you need to stay away from such people. those who do not understand your journey. Don't think that just because we all are humans, we all have developed human body, then don't think everybody is at the same level. That's one mistake that everybody does. They think that, oh, because he or she is of my age, then they will understand. Or if he or she is older than me in physical body's age, then they will understand. Or they may have a better knowledge or much more experience or wisdom of life. That is not true at all. Your wisdom, your chitta vrittis of your soul are according to the age of the life that you are. You take one body, another body, another body, another body, and you keep on going that way. So it depends upon how many lives you have spent and how wise and what choices you have made, of course. It's not about okay, something automatically will happen because just because you are very old and you have led 10 times, you are much wiser than the other thing. But it's all the overall age of your life actually that matters, not the age of the body. So a person may be older than me, and there are, right? There are, and they are not enlightened, they are not self-realized. They were not born with open heart chakra. They were not able to walk their spiritual journey the way I did. And they just do not follow the path of, true path of life, the path of truth. They do not follow that because that requires a lot of courage. You should be yourself and you should be, you know, you should have courage to live the way you feel right, and you do things and choose truth over fear, choose truth over cheating, lying and all those things. So anyways, so these kind of people are around you, and for some time you have to maintain a sanctity. So it's about, you know, and these days another kind of sanctity is needed, which is your mobile phone. All day reading text, all day reading emails, all day reading social media, being on social media. For 2.5 years, when I was walking my spiritual way, for 2.5 years, I was not on any social media at all. I rarely used to look at my phone. Only when somebody called, I would pick up a phone. And that too, because I stayed away from all the social circle and all the friends and people around me, so nobody was calling me anyways other than, but I still used to have phone, because what if in emergency cases somebody calls from my son's school or somebody from the job needs my immediate attention, and that way I need to get involved. So for those reasons I had phone. Otherwise I wasn't looking at social media. I was all the time into my contemplative meditation. You call that, so in the morning when I was doing my sadhana, I was doing vipassana kind of a meditation where you actually do pranayama and you do kriya yoga, and then nicely and very smoothly you go into your meditation. That is the dhyana. So that I was doing in the morning. But then all day I have to work because I have to survive, I have to pay my bills. So I was doing contemplative meditation. Whatever chitta vrittis were showing up, my way of walking the spiritual journey was that I wanted to figure out that natural state of a human being is dhyana, right? Naturally, everybody should stay in dhyana. Then what is it that disturbs it? So I used to pay a lot of attention on and used to do a lot of analysis and focus on what disturbs my dhyana state. And those are my chitta vrittis, feeling very bad about myself or feeling bad about something that has happened in the past, so hanging on to memories, hanging on to the current things and things in life. And that is all about, you know, those are all the chitta vrittis that we have because we have wrong perception of life. So then when I used to question, all right, what's the right perception about it? So because in 2011 my Kundalini awakened and the Guru Chakra was open, in a day or two I definitely used to get an answer that, okay, what's the right perception about it? So that's how I kept on going and kept on fixing myself. So those were the times when I actually maintained sanctity, not just from the physical point of view that nobody should touch me, nobody should, I refrain from even shaking the hands in office or hugging people. See, it's not a permanent thing. Those kind of elimination that we do and we do around ourselves, or the kind of niche or the secluded environment that we create around ourselves, it's not for forever. You are doing it only while you are learning how to walk. It's the same thing like how when a child starts walking, we try to protect him from all the sharp edges and we try to remove obstacles from his path. Otherwise, when he starts running and walking, you don't need to do all these things. So exactly in the same way, it's about sanctity. That you need to maintain sanctity for the time being, for the time while you are walking your spiritual journey. Once you are done, once you are successful, however long it may take, okay? However long it may take, but once you are successful, then you can come back in the world, because it ultimately is a very beautiful world, and it ultimately all your senses and everything, in starting when you do pratyahara and when you, you know, take your senses inside and within you to go inward, but when they find, you find the ultimate expression, the truthful expression of, and a very blissful expression of this life, then it's wonderful, then you come back, okay? So for the time being, while you are walking, while you are doing all this, then you really need to maintain sanctity, okay? I hope you understand that and you do that while you are preparing for starting your sadhana, going to a guru, going to an ashram for a retreat, 10-day retreat, 15-day retreat, or before you start actually. Don't try to do preparatory stuff while you are with the guru. Or when you actually are in the retreat, then you think, oh, till yesterday I was having 99 phone calls a day and I was all on the Twitter and all kinds of social media and all kinds of people were calling me and all kinds of negativity was being spread. Once I go to the retreat, I'll be fine, I'll be staying away. No, that's the wrong thing. That's, you are wasting your retreat actually. You are wasting your time while you are with the guru. You need to do preparatory stuff before you go to the guru. Before you start your yogic practice, before you start your yogic sadhana, before you go to any retreat, before you start attending a program with your spiritual teacher, you need to do all preparatory stuff before going there. That's when you will be able to take full advantage of what is being offered to you, what is being taught to you, right? So pay attention to all these things and see how well you can maintain sanctity, sanctity of physical body, sanctity in your thoughts, and sanctity in your surroundings, in your life. So your lifestyle change is needed before you can be successful in such endeavors. Okay? Namaste. Jai Shivaya.